happy Sunday morning, starting to connect to our mats, to our breath, to our community, which is a committee. One big one. If you like your arms outstretched, stretch them in front of you. If you like them, prefer them under your head, maybe on a block, maybe behind yourself, behind your legs, in between your legs. So just go ahead wherever you are. And if you're not ready to quite settle in there, just go ahead and shift yourself side to side. Slow down the breath, slow down the thoughts. Remember that we always come back to this one place, the breath, throughout. So when things get a little bit crazy and hectic and you might be moving a little bit quicker, remember this breath, this peace. If your arms are not outstretched, begin to bring them in front of you. Spread your fingers. Press down through the heel of the hand and push the mat forward as you push the hips back. Using the inhales and the exhales to move us into and out of space, making it deeper, or backing off. See if you can breathe across the back, across the ribs, across the hips. If you are familiar with Ujjayi breath, the breath of warrior, it's breathing in and out of the nose, slight constriction at the back of the throat. Inhale, lift your head and chest and walk over to your right side and just reach your left arm longer than the right. Allow the left hip to sink down towards the heel. Relax the shoulders. Allow the belly to soften. Inhale, lift yourself up and walk a little bit more to the right side without losing connection of your left heel and hip. Relax the neck and shoulders down. Listen to your breath, it's your guide. Inhale, lift up and walk straight through center, maybe hand over hand to the other side. Right arm longer than left. Pull the hips to the heels. Inhale, lift up and walk a little bit further, maybe a lot for some. And allow your hips to sink back. Inhale, lift your chest, walk your hands back to the front. Exhale, settle a little bit deeper into your hips. Inhale, rise up onto your hands and knees, walk your hands a little bit forward, and just drop your hips down, kind of a hybrid pose, not quite an up dog, not quite a cobra. If it's too much for you, go to your belly. Pull your shoulders back and around, lift your heart up. And then push back to your child's pose. Touch the toes together. Inhale, come forward. We're going to do this a couple of rounds. We'll add some maybe organic movement to it. So if it feels good to you at any time, start to maybe make some circles in one direction and the other. You choose. Just finding maybe some sticky areas and moving around. Let's go the other direction if you haven't. And then come back through center. Let your hips drop towards the floor. Lift your chest up. Spread your feet as wide as your mat. On an inhale, you stretch the heart up. Look over your right shoulder towards your left hip. soften at the glutes a little bit. Push the hips towards the floor. Inhale back to center to the other side. Looking over your shoulder towards the opposite foot. Exhale, come to center, bring your chin down. Now relax your body down to the floor. Keep your hands, if they're not, bring them right by your ribs. Elbows squeeze in, my feet are still wide. Inhale to a cobra, wide-legged, shoulders back, round of the head forward, tailbone down. Are you okay over there? Okay, good. Okay, and let it go. Can you see me okay? Just make sure you can see me. Inhale, lift your chest. Push your pubic bone down, lift your heart. Exhale, one more time, just a nice little cobra, just counteracting that little bit of a bigger back bend for some of us. Squeeze the elbows together. This time, let go of your hands, interlace your fingers, and take the fingers away from you, lift the chest a little higher. Squeeze your elbows towards each other, squeeze your shoulder blades towards each other. Push your pubic bone down, and reach so far that maybe your legs lift off the floor. They don't have to. So listen to your body, and let it guide you into where it needs to be today. Let it come down. Push back to your heels. Child's pose. Inhale back to all fours. Lightly step your right foot in between your two hands. Hands on either side. Maybe on blocks. Let me just check. I hear somebody's unmuted. Okay, gotcha. And settle down. If you need to double up your mat for your back knee, feel free to do that. Pull the shoulders away from the ears. Hug your hips towards midline. Breathe in. Keep your left hand on the inside of the right foot or on a block. Take the right arm, sweep it forward like you're shaking my hand. Doing a lot of long hand shaking these days. And then slide it back and overhead until you come into the twist. Right arm up, hug the hips to center. Lift out of your waistline, spread your fingers and kind of wave hello and then come back to settle. Inhale. And exhale, bring your left shoulder a little bit more towards midline, one more breath. Exhale, hand to the floor. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Straighten your front leg. Head to the shin, toes come up or down. Right hip pulls forward, left hip pulls back. Inhale and exhale. Blocks are always helpful, right? They give the floor a little bit more height to us. Inhale, bend your front knee. Walk your hands to the inside of the right leg. Tuck your left toes underneath you and lift your left knee off the floor. Oh, hi, Margaret. Hug your hips towards midline. Now, I want you to just take your hands and walk yourself over so you're facing the long side of your mat on the left side of your mat. Your feet will probably be not be even, so adjust them out a little bit. Climb to your fingertips, lengthen. Exhale, fold your body in half, round of the head to the floor. Some of you will touch easily, and if you do, you can shorten your stance a little bit. If you're nowhere near the floor, don't worry about it. Maybe make it a little wider, put your hands on blocks, your head on a block. One more breath. Inhale, rise up onto your fingertips. Keep the length in your spine as you spin your body back around to the front. So now if your feet seem to be on a tightrope, move your left foot out a little bit wider or your right foot out a little bit wider. Keep the left hand down, take the right arm out to shake my hand. And sweep it down and back over your shoulders. Spread your fingers. Bring your left side to your right side. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, one more breath. Exhale, hand down. Left knee down. Right leg meets left knee. Sit back on your heels, child's pose. Inhale to all fours. Left leg steps in between the hands. A nice and easy transition. Climb to your fingertips, make sure that your left knee is over your ankle and you're not sitting directly on top of your right knee. Good, breathe. Inhale, right hand is gonna stay on the inside or on a block. Left hand's gonna come out and shake my hand and then sweep it down, up and around, opening up your twist. Hug the left hip towards midline. Good. Try to take tension out of your neck and shoulders. Inhale and exhale. Keep moving left to right, right to left, and meeting in the center. One more breath. Exhale, left hand down. Left leg straightens any amount, toes up or down. Work on pulling the hips towards midline. Head and shoulders are relaxed. Another breath. Inhale, we bend your front knee. Exhale, tuck your right toes under, lift the knee up, and turn to the right side alongside of your mat. Make whatever adjustments you need to on your feet to make them parallel. Rise up onto your fingertips, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold in between your two legs, hang your head down. Maybe you want to grab the outside of your feet and pull yourself a little closer to half. Where you feel it, go for it. If your body says, I'm not ready to do that now, I don't want to do that, then don't do that. One more breath, inhale. Exhale, fold a little closer. Inhale, release your hands under your shoulders, lift your chest. Exhale, walk to the front of your mat. Adjust your feet if they're on tight ropes. Right hand stays. If you want to lower your back knee again, you can lower your back knee. Left arm opens up and twist. Breathe. Hug the hips towards midline. Inhale. And exhale. Find some stretch, find some length. Right side to left side to right side. We meet in the middle. One more breath. Exhale, look down. Listen carefully. We're going to step right foot to the front of the mat. Halfway lift. Hands on shins, everybody. Lengthen your spine. Crown of the head forward, tailbone back. Exhale, fold your body in half. Bend your knees as much as you need to so the fingertips line up with the toe tips on the floor. Tuck your chin into your chest, round your spine, and just hover the fingertips off the floor. Just hanging like a nice ripe piece of fruit. Inhale, hands on shins, lengthen your spine, crown of the head towards the front, tailbone back. Good. Exhale, hang your fruit, right? Let your head hang down. Hover your fingers right off the floor so they're not really touching the floor unless you need to. Keep that hovering feeling, chin to the chest, belly to the spine, pelvic muscles lifted up. Roll slowly to standing. Come all the way up. Roll your shoulders back and around a couple times. And then bring your arms down by your side, spread your fingers. Look down at your feet, measure out the width of your hips if you need to, two fists in between your feet. Pull your shoulders back and down, bring your heart up. Inhale and exhale. Now just rise up onto your tippy toes, just find that. And then lower toe ball, heel to the floor. Sit a little bit back and see if you can lift the bottoms of your feet up and spread your toes without letting your knees hyperextend. So make sure your knees are just in line with your hips pulling upward. And then lower your feet, lower your toes one at a time, fingers down, reaching down like you're gonna pull roots up from the earth. Inhale the arms all the way overhead. Interlace your fingers, turn the palms to the sky, drop your shoulders down. Find that energy from the feet, just like we did earlier, like 2 seconds ago. Rooting down now through the big toe ball of the foot, heel of the foot, pinky toe. Lean to your right side as you exhale, settle in. Lift up and over your beach ball, bring your hands behind your head. Lift your heart up, open, let your head rest in your arms. Inhale, release your hands. Exhale, stay for the breath, inhale, back to center. Up and over to the other side as you exhale. Pretend there's a beach ball underneath you. And then bring your hands just gently behind your head. Open that right arm a little bit more. Maybe you gaze up at the right elbow. Make sure your tush isn't sticking out, so tuck the tailbone underneath you. Inhale, release. Arms come back out. Exhale, settle. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, the hands behind your head one more time. Tuck the tailbone under. Lift up like that beach ball is now behind your back. Exhale, bring your chin to your chest, elbows by your ears. Come down halfway so that your elbows touch the mid-thigh. And now sit your weight back in your heels, sorry Jane, just a short chair. Release your hands and those touch the floor next to the pinky toes. toes of your feet. Sitting back, a little bit of weight if you need to. Put your blocks on either side of your feet. Inhale, reach your arms forward. Sit your weight back into your heels. Now inhale onto your toes. Maybe sweep your arms behind you. Reach your fingers all the way back, crown of the head, tailbone, same line if you can. Exhale, heels down, arms up, interlace fingers, head down towards the floor. Inhaling and exhaling, finding a little bit of space between the collarbones, the weight of the head towards the floor, the sitting bones spread open. Using the strength of your arms and your legs, pull yourself all the way up to standing. Inhale, lift your heart, knuckles to earth. Exhale, bring the arms all the way up, inhaling again. Hands to your heart center, exhale, hands to the floor, or to the sides, towards the floor. Inhale, bend your knees, sweep the floor, Utkatasana, chair pose. Not too long, make it a little bit of a high chair. Come onto your toes and lean forward, bring the arms behind you. Exhale, interlace fingers, heels down, forward fold. Inhale, release hands to the floor or blocks or shins, look forward, inhale. Right leg steps back, exhale. Right arm inside, left arm takes it up and around for a twist. Inhale, and as you exhale, left hand comes down, we spin over to the right side of our mat. Halfway lift, inhale, bring your hands to your heart or your hips, and rise up to stand. Good. Inhale, open up your arms, shoulder height, fingertip to fingertip long. Spin your left toes, your front toes, to the front of your mat. Bend your left knee, warrior two. Pump your warrior, inhale, arms up, legs straight. Exhale, any way you bring your hands back down. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, bring it back down. One more time, inhale up. Exhale, bring it back down. Hold warrior two. So now you get a chance to refine this pose. Knee over the ankle. Outer thighs pull apart. Inner thighs squeeze towards each other. Breathe in and breathe out. Tuck the tailbone underneath you. Can you settle a little bit lower without going into your front knee, but by allowing the hips to sink down to the floor? One more breath, everybody. Exhale, reverse your warrior, left arm up, right arm down. Maybe you do something else with that right arm. Bind it or by a mudra. Maybe you reach both arms behind you. What your body speaks to you is where you need to go today. Make sure that you lift up and over that right side, not dumping into your right side. Hit one more breath. Exhale, windmill down. Turn your back foot forward. Keep your hands on the floor for now, and then take the left arm back up and open. Twist, we've been here before. This time, maybe you want to take the left arm behind you, bind it, or maybe you want to take it over your head and spin your heart to the left side. So, nice, Margaret. Breathe, beautiful, guys. Inhale, and exhale. So feel the squeezing in of that left hip wherever you are right now. One more breath. Exhale, left hand down. Step a little bit closer with your right foot. Square your hips, inhaling. Fold over your legs. Exhale, hang your head. Hands on blocks, shins, anything but your knees. Shift a little bit more of your weight into your back leg. That would be your right leg, unless you're not on the same leg as me, which is okay. Just do the other side later. Inhale and exhale. Come halfway up. Look forward, step forward. Feet can be touching or a little bit wider, your choice. Bend your knees, arms up, chair pose, exhale. Stand all the way up, bring your hands to your heart center as you exhale. Arms come down by your side. Bend your knees, sweep the floor. Utkatasana, chair pose. Sit your weight back in your heels. Exhale, arms behind you on your toes. Interlace your fingers, one finger over, heels down, chest down, head down, arms up. Inhale, release your hands down, lengthen your spine. Exhale, left foot steps back, low lunge. You can always go to the floor with that back knee. Left arm down, right arm reaches to shape my hand, sweep it back and around, open up for your twist. Good, breathe. Hug your hips towards midline, right thigh parallel to the floor. Left knee is nice and strong and lifted. Lift your belly off your thighs. You've got this, guys. Inhale. And exhale, hands down, spin to the left side of your mat. Line up your toe tips and fingertips. Inhale, lengthen. Hands to your heart or your hips, come all the way up to standing. Tuck your tailbone underneath you. Reach your arms out shoulder height. Turn your right toes to the front of your mat. Bend your front knee, warrior two. Three pumping warriors, arms and legs straight, come up. Exhale, open out. Inhale, come up, rise up. Exhale, release. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, release, hold. Now you get the chance to refine this. Bend the knee, knee over the ankle. Pinky toes on the left foot are nice and strong, pressing down. Fingers reach in two directions. Beautiful. Steady eye gaze. Yeah, right, Crosby? Gotta get a little crazy, Crosby. One more minute, one more breath. Exhale, reverse your warrior. Pull that left hip towards the right knee. It's a side bend more than it is a back bend, so reach over to the side. Whatever you do with that left hand, make it yours. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, windmill down to the floor. Spin your back foot forward. Right arm comes up. We twist again. Open up. Reach fingertips. Right hand up, left hand down. Heart moves to the right side. One more breath. Exhale, fold. Step your left foot a little bit closer. Straighten your front leg. Hands on block, shins, or floor. Lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. Shift a little bit more weight into your left leg and let your head come down towards your shin. Isn't that crazy? Hold and breathe. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, left foot to right foot, touching or apart. Bend your knees, Utkatasana, chair pose. Inhale, rise to stand, hands to your heart center. Exhale, arms by your side. Inhale, bend your knees, sweep the floor, here we go. Exhale on your toes, arms back. Whoops, drop your heels down, hands together, lift your head, hands up, head down. Inhale, release hands, look forward. Exhale, right foot back. Right hand down, left arm opens up to twist. I know I left out that side bending twist, so feel free to take it anytime. Exhale, spin to your right side, meeting the long edge of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, hands to your hips, to your heart, rise up to standing. Tailbone tucks. Inhale, open the arms out. Turn your left toes to the left. Bend your left knee, warrior two, exhale. Inhale, just one pumping warrior. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, windmill down. Spin that back foot in. Right foot comes a little bit closer. Actually, yeah, we'll stay here. Breathe. Halfway lift, inhale. So I'm skipping that second twist. Send your weight now into your left leg, balancing on that left leg, L shape. Maybe your hands are on blocks. Just one breath. Exhale, feet together, knees bent, chair pose. Inhale, rise to stand. Hands to your heart, arms by your side. Inhale, bend your knees, chair pose. Exhale, on your toes, arms back. Hands connect, one finger over and fold over Uttanasana, head down. Inhale, release hands, look forward. Exhale, left foot steps back. Right arm reaches up. Open up, twist. Breathe. Maybe you want to take that long stretch if we didn't do it on this side. Exhale, hands down. Spin to your left side. Rise to your fingertips. Inhale. Exhale, hands to your hips or your heart. Rise up to stand. Inhale, arms out, right toes turn. Exhale, warrior two. One pumping warrior, inhale. Exhale, reach two directions. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Exhale, windmill down. Step the back foot in a little bit closer, square your hips. Lengthen your spine. Fold over, pyramid pose. Let your head go. Take the next breath. Inhale, look forward. Bring your left leg up like it's shape of an L. Hips are square, toes point down. Left leg steps together with right. Bend your knees, Utkatasana chair pose. Inhale, bring it all the way up. Bring your hands to your heart center. Bring your arms by your side. Inhale, bend your knees, chair pose. Exhale, come onto your toes. Select your hands behind you, which fingers go in first. Exhale, fold over again. Inhale, release, lengthen your spine. Right leg steps forward, steps back, excuse me, exhale. Left arm opens up for the twist. We've been here, we know this one intimately. Exhale, left hand down, spin to the right side of your mat. Inhale, lengthen your spine, hands to your heart as you exhale, rise up. Inhale. Open up, left toes forward, warrior two as you exhale. Pump it once, inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Listen carefully, straighten your front leg, inhale. A little bit longer in your triangle. And rise up, stand up nice and tall. Move your hips, maybe adjust your back foot if you need to. Move your hips to the right and your torso to the left. Triangle pose, left hand on the floor, shin blocks, maybe your big toe grip. Wherever your body is allowing you to go, make sure that you're not losing the form and the integrity of the pose to what you think is deeper, right? Touching your toes and reaching your toes is deeper, but if you take it out of alignment, it's not worth it, right? So just keep the alignment and go shorter and have more space to crawl into. Inhale. Exhale. Now you can keep your right hand up or put it on your hip. Soften your front knee. Reach your hand in front or to the side or on a block and begin to float your right leg off the floor. And as you get there, start to just adjust. Stacking hips on top of each other, stacking shoulders on top of each other. Flex your right foot. Inhale and exhale. So make sure that hand, the left hand, is not too far forward. Nice, Margaret. Breathe. Beautiful, guys. All right, Celia, I can't see you, but I trust that you're there. Inhale and exhale. Good, now, right hand can stay up, or you can put it back on your hip. We're going to float back into a triangle pose. Open up. Now tuck the left hip underneath you. Reach the right arm up nice and high. Lift your side body up from the left side. One more breath. Exhale, rewind to the floor. Soften your front knee, adjust your back leg, step it in a little bit closer, pyramid pose. Lengthen your spine, inhale. And fold as you exhale. Shift your weight into the back leg and adjust that back hip forward. Shift your weight into the front leg and adjust the hip square. Lengthen your spine, inhale. And exhale, fold. If you have a block, you might want to bring it either into your right hand or place it inside or outside of your left foot. Maybe a little further back than your toes. Lengthen your spine for the inhale. Hands to your hips or heart. Rise up to standing. If that's too much for you, come up any other way. So now just adjust yourself, because just coming up doesn't mean that we've arrived in the space that's right for us. So sometimes I just make my adjustments. I have to widen my feet, shorten my feet, shorten my stance. Inhale the arms all the way up overhead. Exhale, bring your hands behind your back.
Interlace your fingers with forearms, elbows, or perhaps you take a reverse prayer pose. So again, where your body needs to go for this. Shoulders and hips are square. Big toes press down, inhale. Come halfway down, exhale. Crown of the head to tailbone nice and long. Breathe, inhale, and exhale. Find your tabletop first. Inhale, and exhale. Now stay, if you're down lower, come up halfway. Keep your left hand on your sacrum. Reach your right arm out, shake my hand, and then take it across the body if you can get it on the outside. And then notice how you have to adjust that left hip in a little bit more. Turn the shoulders and chest to the left side, left arm up. Twisted triangle, revolved triangle pose. Beautiful. So we all kind of know our bodies, you know, where we can go, where we can push it, where we can back off. We need to back off of it a little bit, yeah? Take another breath. Good. Exhale. Release both hands to the floor. Step your right foot to your left foot. Before we go into anything else, separate your feet hips width apart. Climb to your fingertips, lengthen your spine. Take your two peace fingers on each hand, wrap it around the big toe. Thumb underneath those two fingers, pull evenly, lengthen. And then exhale, pull your elbows to the side, head to the shins, lift your hips up. Breathe in. And empty out. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, release your hands to your hips. Bend your knees. Utkatasana, chair pose, arms come up. Inhale, rise to stand. Exhale, hands to prayer. Inhale, bend your knees, sweep the floor. Utkatasana, chair pose. Exhale, come on your toes, sweep your arms back, interlace your fingers, whichever was opposite. Lower your chest, heels down, head down. Inhale, release your hands, lengthen your spine. Exhale, left leg back, low lunge or high lunge, some people call it, twist open. Reach up, 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 hug the right hip in. Exhale, release the hand, turn to your left side of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, hands to hip or heart. Inhale, rise all the way up. Open your arms up. Warrior two as you exhale. One pump. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Pull that left hip to the right side. And now straighten your front leg. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale. Inhale, come back up to standing. And then adjust your back foot if needed. Reach your right arm forward. Hips go back. Reach out for your triangle. So remember again, the triangle pose. If you can reach your big toe, great. You might have to shorten your stance to do that. But if it's the losing the integrity of the pose into your right hip and dumping into it, then back out of it. Hands up. Higher will always give you that length in your side body or assist you in getting that. Take another breath here in triangle. Look up at your hand or down to your floor. Maybe the left hand's going to come back to your hip or you keep it up as you soften the front knee. Bring the right hand in front of or to the side of your right leg and float the left leg off the floor. Hug your hips in. Stack your shoulders. So don't be in a rush to get to the final pose, because it might take a few breaths to get everything, you know, kind of in the right placement. Shoulder stack, hip stack, flex that left foot, arm up. The leg on the right side is really powerful, but so is the leg that's in the air. Breathe in, breathe in, breathe out. Half moon pose, Ardha Shavasana. Good, now either put your left hand on your hip or keep it up. Inhale, step your foot back, right into that triangle pose. Exhale. Inhale, windmill to the floor. Square your hips, step your back foot in a little bit closer. Lengthen your spine, inhale. As you exhale, fold over your right leg, pull the right hip back and the left hip forward.
forward. We're not here forever. We're going to make adjustments. Inhale, halfway lift, hands to heart or hip, come on up to standing. Good. Bring your arms up overhead, inhale. Exhale, hands behind your back, interlace your fingers. You can also use the strap. Wrists and elbows, forearms, or reverse prayer. Whatever you might have done on the other side is probably going to work on this side. Adjust your hips so that your shoulders and hips are facing almost forward. Yeah, pull the knees up. Inhale. Good. As you exhale, come halfway down. When you get halfway down, make the adjustment, pulling the right hip back, left hip forward if needed. Make sure your knees are lifted, not pulling back behind your hip. Inhale and exhale. Just settle into this for a few breaths. If you go all the way down, that's fine. Keep your back nice and long. And if you are all the way down, make your way back to halfway. Keep your right hand on your hip. Left arm reaches out, and then inside, on top of, or across, outside of your right foot. Lengthen, inhale. Twist your triangle. Exhale, stack your shoulders, right arm up. Hug your hips towards midline. Inhale. And exhale. So sometimes we arrive in a pose, and we're like, great, I'm there. And we forget to breathe, or sometimes we have to make subtle adjustments. That's why we give you a couple breaths to get there most times. Inhale and exhale. One more breath. Inhale, come back to center, lengthen your spine. Exhale, left foot to right. Separate your feet hips width apart, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, soften your knees. Drop your weight back a little bit, not quite chair, and then lift the toes up and wrap the big toe around the wrist. Inhale. And exhale, work your feet around the wrists and let your head come down. Elbows maybe go out to the side, let it go. Massage up your wrists, halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, release your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. No more chair pose for this. Bring your hands to your heart, come all the way up to standing. Heel toe your feet together, bring your arms down by your side. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, just bring your hands to your heart. Send your weight to your left leg and lift your right leg up. Knee in line with hip, or maybe just a little bit higher, flex your foot. Now hug that left hip in as you open the right knee to the side. Try not to collapse into your left hip, so keep pulling it to midline. And either with your hand or without your hand, arrive with the right foot inside of your inner thigh. Hugging hips towards midline, or left hip towards midline. Lift out of your left hip. Press down through your left leg, nice and strong. Inhale, exhale. One more breath. Where your hands go is up to you. You can take them up, exalted, raise the branches of your tree, or keep them at your prayer or anywhere else. Bring the right knee forward, inhale. Come and fly with me. Heart lifts, belly drops, Dikasana. Lift a little bit high. So this is a little bit more of a back bend. Inhale. Exhale. Come a little bit more, a little bit lower towards the floor with your chest, a little higher towards the sky with your foot. Inhale back to your tree. Oh, don't do what I just did. My tree fell over. Breathe. Inhale. And exhale. Now can you grow your tree a little bit deeper, a little bit longer, a little bit taller? Strong like an oak, flexible like a willow. And now take your right ankle above your left knee, flex the foot, not on your knee, so right above it, bend the knee, open it out, and then drop your seat down a little bit lower. See where you want to go. So I did say no more chair pose, but I didn't say single leg chair, Jane. You can take this anywhere you want. So you can come down to the floor with your hands or maybe on blocks. Some of you might want to take this into a flying Pigeon pose, go Michelle. Yep, there you go. Lift that back leg off the floor ever so gently. Some of you will take full flight. And some of you are just enjoying the hip stretch. Send that whenever, okay?
Good. Now, see if you can bring yourself back up to standing with your figure four.
Come up.
Right ankle crosses over left ankle, both feet on the floor. Inhale the arms all the way up. Grab a hold of your right wrist, lift up and over to the left side. Inhale back to center. Exhale, separate your feet, forward fold, let it go. Hang your head. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold to the floor. Chin to chest, roll through standing. Roll the shoulders back and around. Inhale, the arms all the way up. Exhale, bring the prayer to your heart. Send your weight to your right leg without collapsing into it. Lift your left knee up in line with your hip, or maybe just a little bit higher, maybe in line with your belly button. And then open it out to the side. Draw that right hip in. And maybe assist it in coming into your inner thigh, above or below your knee, maybe on the floor. Think about that right hip drawing in and what you do with your arms. Think about it. Choose carefully. Choose wisely. Grow your trees nice and tall. Breathe in. Breathe out. Beautiful. And then bring hands to prayer. Bring your left knee forward. Sweep it back behind you. Swing your arms to the side. Lift your heart, dip your belly. So a little bit more of a back bend than a warrior three. One more breath. Inhale, prayer to the heart. And assist your left leg into tree or not. Hugging hips towards midline, so pull that right hip in, get nice and stable. Exhale, left ankle above right knee, flex the foot. So use the ankle against the top of the thigh, never the knee, to help assist you in opening. And then see if you want more than that. Maybe you want to come down into a seat. Maybe you want to come down with your arms on the inside, kind of on that shin, or maybe you take flight. See if you can do this side too, Michelle. That's it. That's it. That's it. So it's all kind of this playtime, right? You want to play, you don't want to play. That's okay. If you're in flight, come on back. And then let's all meet on our way up to standing. Left leg crosses over right. Inhale the arms up. Grab a hold of your left wrist, lift up and over. Pull up and out. Inhale back to center. Exhale, separate your feet. Fold forward, let it go. Hang your head. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold down. Good. Heel toe your feet together. Come into a low squat. Just no balance, just come down, chin to chest, round and curl, forehead to knee. Pull the belly button all the way to the spine, round to your back. Halfway lift, inhale. Lower your heels and lift your hips just part of the way up. Take your hands behind your calves, either interlace your fingers, wrists, forearms, elbows, or cup your heels from behind. Work your forearms behind your calves. Halfway lift, inhale. And exhale, fold your body in half, working your head towards your shins, your forearms, and your calves to meet. Let it go, breathe, inhale. And exhale. Another big breath. Inhale, halfway lift. Release your grip, fingertips to the floor, lengthen your spine. Exhale, bend your knees, plant your palms, step to a high plank. If I'm not mistaken, this is our first plank today.
wrist under shoulders, spread your fingers, push the earth away, pull your knees up. I don't know, I'm sure you noticed there were no chaturangas in this class. Pull that belly up nice and strong. Exhale, downward facing dog. Can it be done? Can you kick it? Yes, I can. You can certainly do a vinyasa class without vinyasa or without chaturanga. High on your toes, inhale, pull your knees up. Shift forward to your high plank. Look forward, bring your collarbones forward. Lift your right leg off the floor. Bring the knee to the chest, round and curl. Step it back, foot down, downward dog, exhale, hips up. Inhale on your toes to high plank, pull the knees up, look forward, collarbones forward. Exhale, left leg lifts up. Just enough, just enough. Knee to chest, round and curl. Kick it back, lower it, down dog. Inhale and exhale. If you need a break, come to your knees. Stay in dog because it feels good right now. High on your toes to a high plank. Stay here for a moment. As you exhale, lift your hips up, right arm to left ankle, shin or calf twist. Inhale to high plank. Exhale, hips up in the air, left arm to right, look under your arm. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, right hand, left ankle, down dog, that's a twist. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, left hand, right hip, right shin. Inhale, high plank, hold your plank. Hold it a little bit longer, crown of the head forward, tailbone back. Good, tap your knees to the floor, sit in child's pose. Reach your arms all the way out in front of you. Inhale to your forearms. Elbows underneath shoulders, measure the width of your forearms. Take your hands and interlace your fingers, not too loud. So it's just, it's not a death grip finger. Push the forearms into the earth, tuck your toes, lift your hips up, dolphin pose. Walk your feet back a little bit because we're gonna go into a plank. So shift it into plank and then bring your chin in front of your thumbs. And then push back into your dolphin. Inhale, plank, chin in front of your thumbs. Don't collapse your belly, so lift the knees and the belly up. Exhale, hips up, high lower. Inhale back to high plank. Exhale. Now, take a breath and we'll lower the knees for a second. Sit back on your heels. Release your arms. Take a little break on your shoulders for a moment. Reach the arms out. So as you reach your arms out, think about pushing your pinkies to the edges of the mat so you get a nice spreading across your shoulders and your back. And then inhale onto your forearms. We're not going to interlace the fingers because we're going to roll onto one side. So keep your arms down like Sphinx arms. Tuck your toes under, lift your knees up. Plank pose on your forearms. You can have your right arm forward or spin it in line with the front edge of your mat as you come into a side plank variation. Left hand behind your head. You can also have the right knee on the floor, or you can put the left foot on the floor, your choice, or stay upright. Take the elbow, the left elbow to the floor, twist. Inhale, open up. Exhale, twist. Inhale, open up. Exhale, twist. Inhale, open up. Take your left arm up. Now, if you haven't, take your left leg back. Dancer's bridge, left arm over your head. Reach all the way up, up, up. Exhale, spin onto your forearms. Shoulders over wrists. Elbows, excuse me. Onto your other side, left side. Stack. Maybe one leg in front or behind, or maybe the bottom leg to the floor. Right arm behind your head. Exhale, elbow to the floor. Tap it. Lift it up. Two more times, exhale.
Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale up. Right leg behind you. Dancer's bridge, lift the hips, lift the arm up over your head. Exhale, return to your forearms. Now lower your belly, Sphinx pose.
Pull your heart through. Resting on the triangle above your pubic bone, below your hip bones, bring your heart to the center. Close your eyes for a moment, just settle in. And push back to a child's pose. Take your hands behind your back once again. Interlace your fingers, chin to your chest, crown the head to your shin or to your knees. Forehead to your knees, crown of your head to the floor.
Inhale your hips up off your heels, arms up off your back. Maybe a strap is going to help you get a little bit more movement there. Top of the foot and shin down. Pull that belly button all the way up and in.
There should be no weight in your head. Take your time, push through the top of your foot and shin.
Exhale. Exhale, sit on your heels. Inhale, lift your chest up.
Keep your hands behind you, knuckles to the earth, lift your chest. Option to lift your hips up off your heels here. It's up to you. If you do that, see if you can push your hips forward and lift your hips a little higher. So don't dump into your lower back here. See if you can make it a little bit more of an arch in the middle upper. Very nice, guys. Nice. And then exhale your hips to your heels. Sit up, bring the arms overhead. Exhale, reach it out forward.
Inhale, come into a rounded cat spine on your shins, head down, chin to chest. And inhale just to neutral.
Find your way, nothing fancy has to happen, onto your backs. If you have a block and you'd like to use it at any point, go ahead and grab it. Lay down on your backs. And when you get there, hug your knees to your chest and take a happy baby pose.
Holding onto your toes or outer edges of your feet, rocking side to side.
And then settle into your happy baby. And then breathe. Let's do a single leg happy baby today. So take your right leg and extend it out as the left knee stays in happy baby.
If you can't extend that right leg out, just bring it down to the floor even. And just hold it there. So one leg is straight, one leg is bent, or it's on the floor. And the knee, the left foot is hugging towards the right, left rib cage. Breathe in, breathe out. If your right leg is stretched out to the side, you can hold it anywhere but your knee. Keep your tailbone down. And then come back in, switch it up. Right leg stays in, left leg goes out or down to the floor. Think about you, Jane, with this song. I don't know why, I'm not sure. Because I know you like Todd Rundgren. Breathe in, breathe out. Inhale, both legs in happy baby as you exhale. Release the feet, hug the knees to the chest. Head and shoulders lift, round your curl, scoop everything in. Hold on to the top of your foot, shin, maybe your toes. Heels come down to the floor. Let the back go into its little arch there. And then tilt the pelvis. Begin to lift your hips up. Option to put a block underneath your hips. Point your knees forward. Pull your shoulders back underneath you.
Now let go of your feet with your hands, and bring the arms overhead. Inhale. Come a little bit higher, on resting into your shoulders, pushing to your feet. Lift your hips up in the air. Exhale, arms down, upper mid, lower back, down to the floor. Inhale, moving bridge. Lift the hips up, arms up. Exhale, articulate your spine down, arms come down. One more time, we're going to come up and hold this one. Inhale, arms up, hips up. Holding it so you can choose, is this where you want to be? Do you want to put a block under your hips? Do you want to take your hands and come into a big, beautiful back bend? So see where your body leads you today.
And because you did it yesterday doesn't mean that it has to be done today. And because you couldn't do it yesterday doesn't mean you can't do it today. Maybe you can do it today. Maybe today's that day you get lift off. There you go. When you're good and ready to come out of it, top of the head, upper mid, lower back to the floor. Hug your knees all the way up to your chest. You can lift your head and shoulders again. Exhale, head down, arms out shoulder height, feet the width of your mat, pinky edges on the edge of your mat, let your knees fall to the right, take your right ankle above your left knee, make whatever adjustments you think necessary. Inhale, bring your legs to center, cross right all the way over left once or twice, and let the knees fall to the left side. Left hand on the thigh, right arm can go overhead. Any variations, any modifications? Open the arms to the side. Uncross the legs, come back to center, pick up your water bottle and you spill it. Hug the knees back to the chest, and then place the feet the width of the mat. Move your knees to the left side, left ankle above right knee. I was mirroring all day yesterday and I'm getting confused with my right and my left. Inhale back to center, left leg crosses all the way over. Let the knees fall to the right. Right hand can come on the outside of the left leg, and left arm can come up over your head. Breathe. Now cross your legs. Come back to center. Hug your knees to your chest. Round and curl. Lay your head down. Extend your legs out. Stretch your arms over your head. Reach the entire right side of your body long. Reach the entire left side of your body long. Inhale, reach both sides of your body long. Stretching from the center of your body all the way out. Exhale, arms come down by your side, soften your glutes, allow your body to completely surrender into your mat for Shavasana. Softening. Allowing your body to completely melt into the mat, giving yourself this golden opportunity to do nothing. Let your body breathe itself, its own particular pattern. Calm the thoughts, the conversations. Have the luxury of being able to stay here forever, or even just a few more minutes, feel free to stay, turn us off. And if you need to come out of this space, start to make your re-entry softly, quietly, move fingers and toes, wrists and ankles. Draw your knees up to your chest and take yourself onto either side. And then make your way to a comfortable seat with your hands together in your heart center. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for your intentions, your practice, your commitment to this practice. Thank you for allowing me to guide you, share practice with you. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Om peace, peace, peace to all. Namaste, Sat Nam Go, in peace. And everybody have a wonderful Sunday. Best of your day, your weekend. If you're watching this some other time, stay home, stay fit, stay healthy.